This is one I wrote with Jerry Salley. It went number two in the nation on the bluegrass charts. Stayed on the charts for 1 year.
Wow.
Was in the top 10 for about 8 or 9 months. Topped out at number two. And that was a good lick for us. Anybody here born in 46? '46?
Right here.
Really? Oh, wow.
January 30th, 1946.
I'm going to give this to you then. This is for you. It's called 1946. Oldsmobile induces hydromatic drive. You can fill her up with ethyl fluoride at $1.05. Earl took the Opry stage by storm with all of his hot licks. There with Lester and Bill back in 1946. Well, all the folks at Fenway thought it finally was their year. But after 7 hard-fought games, it all became so clear that even Teddy couldn't stop the cards with all their tricks. Seems the Sox would have to wait till after 1946. Oh, the baby boomers were blue, and the buck stopped with old Harry Truman. And the best years of our lives is more than Hollywood's big flick. You don't eat much. Funny thing, it really was back in 1946. My grandpa went to school on that old GI Bill. He was just one of the brave souls who survived the battlefield. But sometimes guilt would get to him when he would reminisce about the friends who never lived to see 1946. Oh, the baby boomers were booming, and the buck stopped with old Harry Truman. And the best years of our lives is more than Hollywood's big thing. Funny thing, it really was back in 1946. Well, sometimes I think I would go back if I could find the way. When hard work and sacrifice were virtues of the day. When anyone could get ahead, no gimmicks, gags, or tricks. And the neighbors that never locked the doors of 1946. Yeah, the baby boomers were blooming. Then the buck stopped with old Harry Truman. Years of our lives is more than Hollywood's big flick. Funny thing, it really was back in 1946.
All right. And that is so true.
More so today than ever.